My name is Gary Smith. I'm a staff chemist with BASF Corporation. I'm currently a supervisor of the R&D facility's pilot plant in Islay, New Jersey.
My name is Bilge Yilmaz. I'm the director for global technology and technical services at BASF Refining Catalysts.
My name is Robert McGuire. I'm a research scientist at BASF. The patent we have is for the use of boron oxide in the FCC process. That is the fluid catalytic cracking process that's used to convert crude oil into fuels and other chemical precursors.
The problem that we are trying to fix, or what we set out to do, was to address the contaminant metals in refining. Essentially, there is a shift towards heavier and dirtier crudes in the field of refining, and refineries want to process a wider range of different crudes. And with those different heavier crudes comes contaminant metals.
These metals are naturally occurring in the crude oil, and when they accumulate on the catalyst surface, they lead to side reactions that decrease the amount of gasoline and diesel fuels that can be produced per unit of crude oil.
In terms of what technology to use, what type of chemistry to explore, we know what we wanted to do, but we didn't know which chemistry to start with. So we explored a wide range of options. At some points, we almost went through different ideas, just looking at the periodic table, what would make sense. And we had a short list at the end, and we started experimenting.
What we've developed is a novel chemical solution that allows us to introduce boron oxide into the FCC process and control the amount of active component that is there in relationship to the contaminant metals. And this leads to a decrease in the reactivity of those metals, and therefore leads to an increase in the amount of liquid products, fuels, and chemical precursors that are produced.
The properties that make boron unique and actually work in the process also work against us in manufacturing. It's very easy in the laboratory to synthesize, but when you start to think about, well, I'm going to make 5 tons an hour of this stuff, how do I do it? That's where we started to involve the manufacturing process engineers, the environmental health and safety groups. We're bringing a new process into the plants. There's a lot of people involved.
The benefit is the fact that you can process the feedstock in a much more efficient way. So instead of converting the feedstock, you know, a portion of it to unwanted chemicals, unwanted products, you are converting it to gasoline and diesel and jet fuel and other base chemicals that one needs for industry. So it is, its main benefit is the fact that you can run the whole process much more efficiently and don't lead to any unwanted, undesirable chemicals or products at the end. Edison is an extremely inspiring figure for me, and to get this award, you know, named after him, it means a lot.
I actually grew up in Edison, New Jersey, and never did I dream that I would actually return here and talk about a patent that I played a role in, and to be honored by the R&D Council of New Jersey is really, really quite an honor.
The BASF Catalyst R&D site is very nearby to the Edison Museum. So to be recognized in that name is quite an honor.